Yesterday, you had a bit of an incident in the car park where you couldn't get out.
I couldn't. The big boom gate jammed.
And you had to get the security man down. And we only know all of this because Lauren put a message up on our team WhatsApp because she was right behind you as all of this was unfolding.
So
while you were causing one of the great traffic jams.
Yeah.
Have a listen to Lauren laughing.
And about 15 minutes later...
It continues.
Yeah.
I can't stop laughing.
I couldn't stop laughing.
Oh, my God.
I was just imagining him in there because he was waving his arms around like he was so angry.
I know it was because the machine wouldn't open and my card wouldn't work and then I had to get someone to come down and open it for me.
The security man.
Yeah, and there's about 30 cars behind me trying to get out through the boom gate.
133353. Have you caused a traffic jam? Troy has. There's a story going around at the moment of a 400 metre long container ship that's holding up traffic in the Suez Canal. I don't know what's happened here, but this cargo ship is absolutely humongous and it has somehow ended up sideways blocking the whole canal. It's like the bloke tried to lay on a 3-point turn and he's got almost around and gone, actually, I'm not going to make it.
No.
Come around.
It's like the scene in Austin Powers.
Come around.
It's an extraordinary picture.
It really is. A witness said they had a bunch of tugs trying to pull and push it earlier, but it was going nowhere. There's a little excavator trying to dig out the bow, and I think you've got no hope of getting that thing around. Is it still there?
I'm on Vessel Finder right now, and it's still there.
It's still there.
Yeah.
It's 400 metres long.
Yeah.
400 metres long.
And how wide's the canal?
I'm not sure. It's 59 metres wide, the ship. The lane's water surface width is 313 metres.
It's less than the length of the ship.
The photo's up on Instagram, by the way, at Marty Sheargulcher.
Go check it out, yeah.
Look at this thing. It is so wedged in there. And there's a whole line of ships behind it, obviously. It's the Suez Canal.
It's a major transit route.
It's how you get through.
Mm. Yeah.
And they have backed up 4 kilometres. Have you caused a traffic jam? Have you had that moment in your life where you go, oh, no, it's me. I'm ruining this for everyone.
Traffic jam. Woo! When you're already late.
133353 callers. When did you cause a traffic jam?
Jam. When you're already late.
Like this ship in the Suez Canal.
Well, and also like you in the car park yesterday when you couldn't get out.
Yes.
Lauren sent a group message to our WhatsApp of just having a chuckle at your expense.
Just laughter went on all afternoon.
She was behind you, watching you call security down.
Yeah, arms flailing.
My arms were out the window.
Arms flailing.
What's happening? That's what it was like. I was like, God, again.
F and hell.
What? F and H.
I'm not the only one. Thankfully, Nick in West Footscray. What happened?
It was the day I hit Australia's most famous bridge, the Montague Street Bridge.
Oh, no, Nick.
I hit it back before it was cool to do it, Marty. It was back in the 80s, so then all these Johnny-come-latelys have come in over the top of me claiming that they've hit it.
Oh, no, it seems
so it was
to happen.
18.
Yeah, go on.
18, first job. I had a ute, and it was a conveyor belt on the back of it, and didn't even think... And I've hit it that hard, the conveyor belt has shattered into 1,000 pieces, which meant both sides of the road were covered in debris.
Oh, no, Nick.
And both sides, I didn't know what to do, and obviously packed up that day and didn't work there again the following day.
Did you flail your arms in the air at any time, Nick?
Flail?
Flail? Flail? What even is that?
I think
maybe it was just me.
Will's got one on Instagram for us.
Yeah, at Marty Sheargold Show. Tysky73 reckons his mate's truck caught fire on the Monash.
Oh, my God.
That caused a few dramas, he reckons.
Sure. Oh, my God. Anything on the Monash is a drama, let me tell you.
James and Frankston South, what happened?
Yeah, g'day.
G'day, James.
How you going, guys?
Good, mate.
Awesome. Hey, oh, you wouldn't believe it. I was going through Kangaroo Valley, right?
Yes.
New South Wales, the most beautiful part of the country. Yeah. I was heading down to my sister's in Nowra.
I was born in Nowra, James.
Oh. Oh, no way. What a great town. Actually, she's out in Falls Creek.
Okay.
On Jarvis Bay Road. But anyway, I was driving through the bloody Kangaroo Valley, yeah, and my transmission died.
Oh.
So I got stuck in second gear, and I'm doing about like 25... maybe 25K.
All the way through town?
All the way through Kangaroo Valley. And there was like 100 cars behind me going up and then down the valley.
Oh, James, did you flail your arms at all?
All the way through town. Oh,
he did.
The Mighty Sheargold Show. Triple M.